Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Carmine Zabia for Explain America, and the judge in Trump's Stormy Daniels hush money case, he went berserk on the bench. Before we get started, please make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Those little things really help us out, and they help our channel continue to grow. Judge Juan Merchan had a hearing today in which he's to determine if Trump is going to be fined, if he's going to be admonished, if he's even going to go to prison or, well, behind bars in a lockup, a holding cell, as it were, for as many as 30 days. He had a hearing about this, and if you think that this trial is going to be fair, today likely casted some doubt on that for you, as the judge just tore in to Trump's legal team. And if you look at the things he was saying, the thing telling them they lost credibility with him, just vicious, vicious attacks on his attorneys, questioning basically their credibility, questioning their honesty. It was insane. Something that you really don't see a judge do, but this judge did it. And I think that any belief that this was going to be a fair trial for me, any shred of belief that I held on to, that maybe Trump could get a fair trial here, was obliterated, destroyed after this. I want you to watch this report and let me know what you think when you like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'm Carmine Sabia for Explain America. We love you guys. God bless you. Take care, everybody.
Happening from inside the courtroom. This was just happening a few moments ago. Todd Blanche, the former president's attorney, saying that Trump has a, quote, group of folks who work with him and find articles that they think Trump's audience should read. This is all pertaining to whether or not some of these posts violate the judge's gag order about talking about people who are involved in the case and the jury. And then this was a very important moment when the judge said there is an active action required to repost things, and he doesn't buy that by calling it a repost, your client can wash your hands of it. That seems to be a reference to the Truth Social post where Trump was quoting Jesse Waters, who is a Fox commentator, who was saying that that perhaps the jury has been stacked with Democrats who lied their way onto the jury. The judge not buying some of the explanations coming from former president and his legal team. And Merchan said at one point he wants to hear an assertion, this is important, under oath, that Trump believed he wasn't violating the gag order when he made the posts at issue now. So it sounds like the judge is turning up the heat a little bit on the former president. I want to talk about this a bit further. Former Trump campaign advisor and CNN senior political commentator David Urban joins me now to discuss. Our legal panel back with us, Elliot and Joey. David, let me go to you first. You've been dealing with Trump for a long time. I mean, you know that he's pretty much on top of what goes out on social media under his name. So when he's quoting Jesse Waters like that, he knows what he's doing, right?
Look, the former president, if anything, is very, very media savvy, right? And he's sharp. So I don't understand, and pardon my Neanderthal brain here, but I'm not sure I could completely understand that Judge Merchan asking if Trump is aware of what Jesse Waters had posted previously.
Yeah, David, I'm sorry to interrupt, but the judge is now saying to Trump's attorney, quote, you're losing all credibility with the quote. So it doesn't sound like this is going well.
Yeah.
Back to you, David.
Yeah. I was just going to say, so I'm not sure what the underlying text was that Jesse Waters was putting up, but Donald Trump knows what he's put what he's posting. And look, the crux of this, you take it back to what Paul was saying, I think what particularly is irritating to the former president is that Michael Cohen is going, you know, on these various social media platforms every night for hours and you know, taking a pipe to Donald Trump, and Donald Trump is not permitted to kind of punch back at Michael Cohen. I think that's is the nub of the issue here, and that's what's rubbing Trump
But
wrong.
He's got a gag order, right, David?
I mean, no, so, no, I, you know, Jim, like, I'm not arguing. Yeah,
life is tough, you know. Yeah.